Assalamu alaikum. Welcome all to Easy Hem Anatomy channel. In this video, I discuss the emerging osteocyte. It is the mature bone cell enclosed by the bone matrix that was previously secreted as osteoblast. The process of transformation from osteoblast to osteocyte takes approximately 3 days. It reduces 70% of volume during the process of formation of osteocyte. This is mesenchymal stem cell. It converted into osteochondral precursor, and then it converted into pre-osteoblast, then immature osteoblast, then mature osteoblast. These are the fate of mature osteoblast, some apoptosis and some converted into lining cell and some converted into osteocytes. You see, this is osteoblast, and here the process of formation of osteocyte. This is osteocyte. This is the electron microscopic picture of the osteocyte. This is nucleus, the organelle, rough endoplasmic reticulum, lysosomes. The feature of the osteocyte. Osteocytes do not divide, and they are long-lived cell and half-life about 25 years. And both osteoblasts and osteocytes develop in mesenchyme. The osteocyte is communicate with another osteocyte through cytoplasmic process, and it also communicate with the endothelial cell of the bone marrow, pericyte of the blood vessel, and also osteoblast. This is one osteocyte, another osteocyte, they communicate with each other by cytoplasmic process. Osteocytes are metabolically active and multifunctional cell, and they respond to mechanical force applied to the bones. Similar to the other cell, the osteocyte also has primary cilium that may be involved in mechanosensation and molecular signaling. The loss of the sex steroid led to increased prevalence of osteocyte apoptosis, and conversely, estrogen and androgen inhibit apoptosis of osteocytes as well as osteoblasts. The histological feature of osteocyte. It is typically smaller than the osteoprogenitor cell. Cytoplasm less basophilic than the osteoblast. Each osteocyte develop long process that radiate from the cell body, and number of cell process is average 50 per cell. This is the cell body of the osteocyte. It's located in the lacunae, and this is the cytoplasmic process. It's located within the canaliculi. The percentage of the dead osteocyte, 1% at birth and 75% at the 8 decades of life. There are 3 types of osteocyte: quiescent osteocytes, formative osteocyte, and disruptive osteocyte. These are the features of quiescent osteocyte. It contains less amount of rough endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex and osmophilic lamina seen near the cell membrane. The formative osteocyte, the amount of rough endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex are more, deposit bone matrix, exhibit certain characters similar to osteoblast. Resorptive osteocyte, amount of rough endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex are abundant, and lysosomes are conspicuous. Degradation of the bone is occurred by the resorptive osteocyte. The formation of the osteocyte from the osteoblast. This process takes 3 days, and at first, osteoblast secrete large amount of extracellular matrix, nearly 3 times its own cellular volume. So, osteoblast lost 70% of its volume, and it reduced its cell organelle, and cytoplasmic process are begin to form. Each osteocyte contains 50 cell process, and each osteocyte occupy a space called lacunae. The osteocyte also has primary cilium that may involve in mechanosensation and molecular signaling. Recent discoveries show the osteocytes are metabolically active and multifunctional, response to mechanical force applied to the bones. It also responds to reduce mechanical stress like immobilization, muscle weakness, weightlessness in space. Mechanical force of the bones causes flow of intestinal fluid out of the canaliculi and lacunae on the compressed side of the bones. Movement of the interstitial fluid generates a transient electrical potential. This transient electrical potential opens voltage-gated calcium channel in the membrane of osteocyte over which tissue fluid flow, resulting increase in intracellular calcium, ATP, nitric oxide concentration, prostaglandin E2 synthesis. After expression of genes responsible for bone formation, the stressed region of the bones will have the largest deposition of new bone. When mechanical stresses are reduced, osteocytes secrete matrix metalloproteinase, which degrades bone matrix. Only recently was the complexities of the osteocyte network even described. These cells grow out in the bone space, interacting with ion signal through long dendritic process, creating a fascinating system of intercellular connection. These cells interact not only with each other but also with other cells. Osteocyte can stimulate and increase osteoblast formation. So it indirectly increase bone formation by increasing the number of the osteoblast. Osteocyte also increase the osteoclast, and so lacunar and canalicular remodeling is occur, bone resorption is occur. So regulation of the bone formations is occur by osteocyte. The recent journal finding describe just a handful of proven role of osteocytes play not just in bone health and homeostasis, but also their role in much bigger signaling network. Osteocytes play a mechanosensory role. The dendritic network of osteocytes allow communication across large area of the bone, and these cells are subject to all the stress and strain of the bone matrix itself. Again, from the Dallas et al., the figure demonstrates how osteocytes interact with both osteoblast and osteoclast, and their influence is greater than previously thought. Clinical anatomy. Osteocyte cell death can occur in associate with pathological conditions such as osteoporosis, osteoarthritis, which leads to increased skeletal fragility linked to the loss of ability to sense microdamage and or signal repair. Oxygen deprivation that occur as the result of immobilizations, bed rest, glucocorticoid treatment, withdrawal of oxygen have all been shown to promote osteocytes apoptosis. The multiple myeloma bone disease is characterized by the exacerbated bone resorptions and the presence of osteolytic lesions that do not heal because of the concomitant reductions in the bone formation. Osteocytes produce molecules that regulate both bone formation and resorption. Recent findings suggest that the lifespan of the osteocyte is compromised in multiple myeloma patients with bone lesion. In addition, multiple myeloma cell affects the transcriptional profile of osteocyte by upregulating the productions of pro-osteoclastogenic cytokines, stimulating osteoclast formation and activity. Further, patient with active multiple myeloma has elevated circulating level of sclerostin, a potent inhibitor of bone formation, which is specially expressed in osteocyte in bones. So this is all about osteocyte. If you like this video, please press the like button and please subscribe my channel.